Yo, this is Chris Blair. How you guys doing? Just sitting here having a coffee. So I couldn't get organized to do an official webinar this week. A bunch of stuff has been going on, but we'll go back to doing a regular webinar, like a presentation style webinar next week. Doing a live stream instead. So you're still gonna be delivering some awesome free content to you guys. So to help you guys have success with your e-com stores, help you have success with Christmas. And with the Christmas sales season, guys, we are literally now, I think it's October 10th, right? I think it's October 10th. Guys, when you work from home and you don't actually go to an office, you forget the days. In fact, I didn't even realize, apparently, Monday is a national holiday in Japan. I just found out it's coming Monday. I lose track of the calendar because I work at home. I'm not going to an office. Anyway. So I want to talk about something that's really important, because we are literally 5 days away. The big boom in sales start picking up is literally around October 15th, 16th. There's some differences in niches and some of that, but October 15th, 16th really is when it starts to pick up, and this is going to get steady. The intensity is going to grow. November is really good. Black Friday weekend, and then that first 2 weeks, 3 weeks of December is insane. I mean, it is fucking insane. I mean, you can make a lot of money in just a short period of time. Now, if you're doing print on demand, which I think you should be, right? Now, guys, I'm not saying that you shouldn't do dropshipping. If you have a good dropshipping supplier and it's reliable and stuff like that, you can make a lot of money with dropshipping. You just gotta be a lot more careful. But the thing about dropshipping, and unfortunate, what's the word I want to describe? A big disadvantage of dropshipping is that you're using, most likely you're using e-packet, unless you're using a fulfillment center, right? You guys, you're bulk shipping to a fulfillment center, whether the fulfillment center be in China or that fulfillment center be in the United States. Now that there's all these fulfillment centers that are starting to pop up in China, not all, there's a couple of them, where literally they bulk ship stuff to that place in Guangzhou or wherever, Shenzhen, and then they've worked out special shipping arrangements and they ship across. But in my course of mastermind, one thing we're doing for dropshippers is we have worked out a special relationship with a private fulfillment company based out of Guangzhou, where literally, if you're dropshipping, you can have your stuff sent to that place. They've got a special arrangement with DHL and FedEx and a few other these shipping companies, and they're literally shipping the United States in 7 days. That's right. And so if your stuff's sitting there, right, they pack it the same day the order comes in, the next day. So literally, you can get your stuff to the United States using our special proprietary ecommerce exclusive dropshipping fulfillment center that we have a relationship with. This, but they're not out open advertising public, only available to ecommerce members. You can literally be, once your stuff at their facility, right, you could literally be getting your stuff to the United States in 8 to 9 days. So that actually eliminates one of the biggest problems with dropshipping, with the long shipping times. Right, the 2 or 3 weeks shipping times. Because guys, what happens when you drop ship from China is the supplier doesn't necessarily make the stuff. You make an order, but they usually wait 3 or 4 or 5 days before they ship it, and then you got the 2 to 3 weeks for e-packet. Because even though they say 10 days, that's bullshit. I mean, it almost never goes that way. Usually it's 2 weeks. So there's at least a 17, 18 day waiting period and the customer's pissed off. So, and that also really hurts you big time at Christmas. The other thing that hurts you big time at Christmas is, guys, what's your realistic drop dead date? What is your realistic date you can no longer make it for Christmas? We're talking maybe, if you're lucky, December 4th or 5th. Usually it's earlier than that, okay? But if you're doing print on demand, right, with custom companies that we use, right, and ecommerce, of course, the ones we use, right, some of them have fast shipping. So, and based in the United States. So literally, I will sell all the way to the 21st or 22nd of December. And of course, I will upgrade the shipping right at the last minute, right? Guys, that is a huge, massive advantage because all the late Christmas shoppers out there. There's a huge number of people who put off Christmas shopping to the very last minute. And while the rest of the marketplace is done advertising for Christmas, I could still be pushing on December 20th because I can upgrade it. You know, because I use print-on-demand supplier that ships. Some of the T-shirts we sell, like, they will ship the same day. Hats we sell, they'll ship the second day, right? And then I upgrade the 2 day ground shipping, bang. I can be selling all the way until called very late in the season. And if you're drop shipping and using our proprietary system, guys, you can be, because of the shipping arrangement we've arranged for this drop shipping company, you could be literally selling all the way to about the 15th of December. Incredible opportunity. And it sets up for a huge, huge advantage over the rest of the marketplace, right? Now let's talk about remarketing and retargeting. I just talked about something, guys. Whether you're in my course or mastermind or not, you should be thinking about your shipping and delivery times. It's massively important, which is why I set up this, helped set this fulfillment to help my people make a mastermind, be able to get that from China 7-day shipping arrangement, right? And you know, why I'm also, on the other hand, if you're not dropshipping, I recommend print on demand. Or actually, the reality is you can do a hybrid model, you can do both. All right, so let's talk about remarketing, guys. Remarketing is massively important during, especially during Christmas. It's important all year round, but especially important during Christmas, because even though people will be in a buying mood, they're gonna click over to your website. A lot of people will say, okay, that's cool, let me think about that. They may bookmark or they may leave a tab open, but they think, oh, I'll think about it, let me see what else is in the marketplace. And then they'll forget about your product and it's gone. So you gotta remind them you're just. So how can you retarget, right? How can you retarget remarket? Well, there's a few different ways, okay? One is the traditional dynamic retargeting ads. You gotta set up a product feed with Facebook, and the one I recommend is Pixel Perfect. They have a great system. It makes your pixel more accurate. It automatically creates the feed for you. This is a few little steps you gotta do to make it work for you, but it's all set up. And three, it's very affordable. I mean, Tony, the owner, and I have trying to have a very good relationship with Tony. He's based out of the UK. He's done a really good job of creating Pixel Perfect and making it awesome for us. And so, great product. In fact, knowing their server cost and everything that involved in running the app, it's a shocking to me they can charge $15 a month. They should be charging more for that. But anyway, incredibly affordable, so it's totally worth it. Your pixel will be more accurate, and you'll get the feed, right? So, get a product feed, and then you set up a dynamic retargeting ad. Okay, now what? People ask me, what is dynamic retargeting ad? So what dynamic retargeting ad is this. Okay, so what will happen is Facebook will track what product page that people visited, right? So they'll say, okay, let's just say they say, I love dogs t-shirt, okay? They visit your I love dog t-shirt, right? And so when the person goes back to Facebook, they'll show them that image of the I love dog, but it's a multi-image ad. And the other images they'll show will be like, other stuff related to that, right? So first, Facebook will just say, okay, look, this is an I love dog t-shirt. Okay, I'm gonna show other t-shirts. Okay, so let's just say they go and they visit I love dog fleece. They're gonna show I love dog fleece, and they're gonna show fleece jacket, which are very good products to sell during the winter. Then I'm gonna show 1, 2, 3, 4 other fleeces. That's what Facebook will do in the beginning, because Facebook doesn't have any data on your website. But over time, Facebook will gather data on your website and they'll realize, okay, the people who go to the I Love Dog fleece jacket also have added this to the car or also bought this. And so Facebook will literally track your website, learn your website for you, and then proceed to show other product offerings in that multi-image ad that Facebook knows, based on the data that's gathered, that people who have gone to the I Love Fleece dog jacket, and it will show them that. And so it increases your chance of making conversions. So dynamic retargeting ads are a really important thing to do, right? Now, one thing I have to say, and I've run into this personally, right? And this is how transparent I am. I have one website in the beer niche that is very edgy, racy. A lot of bad language on that website. And for a while, I was able to use dynamic retargeting ads with no problem, and Facebook was fine. As of late, I'm not able to use dynamic retargeting ads on that website. I get denied. It says breaks policy because of profanity. Okay, so what I've learned there is now Facebook has a policy that if the site has too many, see, because Facebook is going to randomly choose products, not random, but it's going to systematically choose products, right? So it's not random. It's systematic and choose products, and it could be one of the products with the bad word, so Facebook's denying that. So unfortunately, on the two websites I'm running right now, I can only personally do dynamic retargeting ads on one of them, because one site is very clean and no bad language, and it's a different market and different place, so it's working great for me. But on the on one of my other sites, it's not working because of the language issue. And so you get to realize that some of your websites, depending on the type of products you have on your website, you could run into that issue as well. All right, that's one way to retarget. Okay, another way to retarget, and I love this. This is the simplest thing and it's powerful. And this is something that I'm able to do on both my websites. Something I'm doing right now on that beer site with all the bad language is whatever product I'm advertising on Facebook and it's converting, I create a custom audience for it. So I create a custom audience, right? So I'll take that website URL and I'll create a custom audience for that URL, right? So you go in and create a custom audience. So now I've got an audience of people who are just visiting that website, and I put the last 30 days. And I will literally advertise them and send them right back to the original post that they saw. I literally take them right back to the original post. Why? Because they're familiar with it, right? And it really converts well. It's amazing. Send them right back to the original post, converts well. How you doing, Douglas? How you doing, Stefan? How you doing, Robert? How you doing, Cindy? Okay. So that's the second way to retarget, right? Take them right back to the original post, retarget there, right? So that's a really cool way, okay? Mark, how you doing? Okay, so some other ways you can do retargeting, right? You could retarget using AdRoll or other services, right? And retarget, by the way, if you're using AdRoll and these other services and you're trying to use dynamic retargeting, they're also strict about profanity as well, so you're gonna run into that issue. On one of my sites, I'm not able to do that. I have to do a different style of retargeting, which I'm going to get in here in a second. But you could do a dynamic retargeting ad with AdRoll, where you could retarget all over the web, right? So if you use AdRoll, they're going to retarget for you on Google. They're going to retarget for you on Pinterest. They're going to retarget for you on Reddit, on Twitter, whatever, right? All these different websites that are connected to their system. It's awesome. Okay. So another way you can do is. When I told you guys I had trouble with dynamic retargeting ads on one of my two websites because of the profanity issue, right? So what I have to do on that other website, the one that the profanity issue is, I have to go in and I have to go into Google and I have to create specific custom audiences, or go into Pinterest, create specific custom audiences, and YouTube, go on and create specific custom audiences, and so on and so forth, and then directly create an ad for that product that I'm pushing. Okay, and that's how I get around that profanity, because usually the product that I'm advertising to get approved, although it may be a bit edgy and racy, I go easy on the profanity, which allows it to get approved. So, and ideally you should be doing both. I mean, to have a dynamic ad is great, but also you want a direct ad that's directly back to the original product, okay? You want both, okay? So that's another way. And then the other, last but not least, is you definitely want a cart abandonment series, okay? Now, what is a cart abandonment, okay guys? So cart abandonment, maybe you guys may not know, but there's Klaviyo. Now, if you guys don't want to pay for Klaviyo, just go into the Google apps and type in cart abandonment. There's a few cheap options out there that are reasonable, and they do an okay job. And it's a great way to start if you're on a budget and you can't afford Klaviyo. Although Klaviyo is free to start off with, by the way, and it gets only more expensive as you bring in more customers. But yeah, I highly recommend Klaviyo, but that's a different issue. The point is you want some sort of cart abandonment series, right? What happens when the cart abandonment? People say, well, not all my people are getting mailed. Well, you only get mailed if they go to the checkout section and they actually fill out the information. They actually put in their email address, okay? The cart abandonment mails cannot send email to every person who has a cart. Something that a lot, I know that sounds, to those of you who are experienced marketers, it may sound like, why are you pointing this out? I've been in coaching and training since 2014, and I can tell you for a fact that I get asked this question actually a lot. You know, someone added the cart, why, you know, I had 10 people add the cart, and only three of them showed up in my cart abandonment email sequence, you know, and they were sent. What happened there? Well, if they don't put in their email address, then there's no way for these cart abandonment apps to know who to send to, okay? Right? There's a thing called browser abandoned. That's a different technique, and that's more advanced. We're not going to talk about that today. So those of you thinking, what about browser abandoned? That's something that's more complicated, and I'm going to just ignore that today because I want to make this doable for everyone who's watching this video. Okay, so cart abandonment can only work if they go as far as putting in their email, which surprisingly a lot of people do. A lot of people go there with the intention. They will say, okay, I'm going to fill out my information, I'm going to put in my email address, but I'm going to buy later for whatever reason, right? Maybe they don't have their credit card with them. Maybe they don't remember their PayPal password. And guys, and here's the sad but true reality, okay? Most people in the world are living paycheck to paycheck, okay? They have rent, they have children's expenses, they have all sorts of stuff that they have to pay, and they have bills. So they have this much money that they can spend extra, right? Whether that be $200 a month, $300 a month, $400, whatever it is, right? It varies. And just because a family's rich, right, rich per se on paper, doesn't necessarily mean that they're cash flow rich. I mean, I'll give you an example, okay, guys? I'm gonna be just how transparent I am. I grew up in an upper middle class family. My dad was a pretty well-known attorney, okay? We did well. We lived in a pretty fancy house. We had a couple nice cars. I went to private school for junior high school, and I wanted to play sports, and I insisted on going back to public school and fought my parents because I really wanted to play sports at this one school, and my dad finally wheeled it to my request. And so I went actually going to public school for high school because of I wanted to play sports with these guys, and I was a good athlete. Anyway, so but then also my parents were saving for retirement and all sorts of other stuff, okay? So actuality, even though from the optics, right, it looked like we had a lot of cash, the reality is my mom sometimes said, hey, we're a little bit short on cash right now, cash flow right now, I have to wait till next month. Because what happens is your expenses go up. Expensive house, expensive car, private schools, investing more every month into your retirement plan than the normal person does. So just because a family might look rich, and that may be true in total assets, but that doesn't mean that they have cash on hand just to go out and spend on shit, okay? So there's a good number of people, and I'm bringing this up because you'd be surprised. The amount of time that we have seen people say, we have been communicating with customers, and they say, oh, I can't afford that hat, I can't afford that bag until the 25th till I get paid. We have seen that, and it seems like, oh my God, $23 product. We've seen that a lot. I mean, it is not even uncommon. I get this happens almost daily. We get a comment saying, I can't afford it right now till I get paid. Okay, so most people are living paycheck to paycheck, right? That's the reality. Even the upper middle class, I just talked about my family experience growing up as a kid. Right? Unless you're in the real rich class, right? So, what does that mean? That means that there's a good number of people out there who will go with the legit intention of, okay, I'm filling out this information, right? And I'm gonna add my card. Okay, I'm a little bit short. I've only got a couple $100 more to last me for the next 4 or 5 days. Okay, maybe I should just hold off and wait for my next paycheck. And I don't wanna put it on, so that happens a lot. That happens a lot, okay? All right, and especially nowadays with the credit world where people are living above their means, okay? So, I mean, we gotta keep that in mind. So, you gotta have a card abandonment series in place to follow up with these people. It's really, really, really important, okay? All right, now those of you who think you got value out of this, to be honest, this is just the tip of the iceberg. If you truly wanna have success with your e-com store during Christmas, I suggest you do one of two things. One, sign up for my Ecom Vantage course and mastermind. It's $1,000 a year. You get my ongoing support. I'm in the group every single day answering questions. I'm in doing live streams in there 2 or 3 times a week. It's a full-on course covering everything you need to know about ecom. I mean, you'd be shocked. I had someone join just last week, and literally 3 days into, he said, I can't believe all the stuff I didn't know or realize. Okay, and so this is a guy, who's been around this business for 3 years, and that's exactly what he messaged me. Okay, so one takes one or two ideas in that course of mastermind, pay for the $1,000 a year. You can pay for it in a heartbeat. Okay? Now, and the other option is my private coaching. Right? I can work with you one-on-one. I can look over your shoulder and help your business. It's a big difference having someone like me, who's been around this game since 2012, work with you directly. Okay? It can make a massive difference in your business, right? Not just now, but permanently, long term. Alright? So private message me if you're interested in my private coaching. I'll put the link to ecommerce, course and mastermind in the thread below. And we'll see you in the next video. Cheers.
Thanks for watching the video. To watch the next one, click right here. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button right here.